y'all, Faith, it is the time that Faith goes out of school, which is 2 freaking 20. Dorian is having a medical emergency. Like, so I'm getting the kids ready to go get Trent's prescription, the one that I told you guys about in the last vlog. And literally, like, I'm getting Dorian dressed, everything's fine. Then I'm realizing, like, as I'm putting on his pants, like, he starts, like, reacting and, like, tensing up his body and, like, screaming, like a pain scream. Now, Dorian is autistic, as y'all already know, but he, and I'm gonna have to put the volume up on this because I don't want to speak too loud, but he, I know his cries. I know when he's crying because he's hungry, he's lonely, he's in pain. I can differentiate his cries. This was an intense pain cry. So then I started touching his leg, like squeezing certain parts of it, so I could see if I'm pushing the baby's shoulder. That's why I'm out of breath. Yeah, I started squeezing certain parts of his leg to see like where he was experiencing pain. And so I got around his knee area. I don't know, he barely would let me touch him. So I started flexing his knee and straightening it back and forth, back and forth. And I feel like that made it worse. Because by the time I had his sneakers on and tried to stand him up, his leg was shaking uncontrollably and it wasn't straight. He's autistic, so naturally they walk on their tiptoes. He doesn't walk on his tiptoes a lot though. But with this pain, he was walking on his tiptoe and limping. So I feel like whatever was happening with him, I made it worse. Well, I don't know. So now I'm rushing to the school to go get Faith and rushing back home. And then I'm gonna get ready to take him to the hospital. No, those were not in my freaking plans for the day at all. And I just hope he's okay. I hope nothing's broken. He's walking on it, so I don't think so, but he doesn't even want me to touch him. And I know I'm gonna have a hard time at the hospital because he is autistic and he's nonverbal and he's experiencing pain, so it's hard to deal with him, like, when certain things like this happen. And then even with a COVID test that he's gotten when he was maybe 1 or 2, it was hard, you know. So I'm gonna keep you guys posted on what's going on and try to film as much as I can. If I don't, I'm gonna come back on camera and explain what's going on. So me and Trent are sitting in the schoolyard. On the one day, Faith's class never comes down late. The one day when I have a medical emergency, her class is coming down late. So we're just waiting. When I get home, I'm gonna call an ambulance so that the ambulance could come take me and Dorian straight to emergency. Hey everyone. So it is September 28th, about 3:36 p.m. And it is a new day from the last clip that you saw. I'm gonna let you guys know that Dorian is okay. By the time Benny got here, Benny is my partner, if you're not familiar. By the time Benny got here, it's like nothing was wrong with Dorian. Like, he was completely fine. Nothing. He was acting normal, walking normal. We were flexing and extending his leg.
Dorian, Trent.
You both just ignore me. Whoop. Be careful.
We're gonna be on Metro World Kids. When we finish, you can each grab a flyer like this so you can know where to. 8:30, there we've got flyers that look like this. And at the back, we want you to fill in your information completely. Because we're going to take this and we're going to put it in the raffle, and I need to know where you live and your cell phone number so I can call you to say, you won! Okay? And it's also important because then we can let you know when we have Christmas.
Yes.
Because Christmas, we're giving you all Christmas gifts.
Okay, everybody ready? Say, dear God, thank you for today. Thank you that I can have fun. Dear God, today I invite you to be here with us. Help me learn.
I want to make sure it's safe. Watch out. We're going to put that chair right here. We're going to put the other chairs right here. Now, what's your name?
Avery.
Avery, okay. Turn around. I want everybody to see you. I want you to stay here. What's your name? Come here. Okay, look at your friend. Look over there. Stand on next to him. So, Carlin is going to go in the back with the balloon. It's not going to fall on your head, I promise. Okay. Carlin is going to stand in the back with balloon. The girls got purple balloon. Girls, say purple balloon. Boys, you got what color balloon? You got
gray
balloons. Yellow balloon. Sweetie, you're going to have to sit down on the carpet. I don't want them to run over you. Make sure your feet are inside. To get the purple balloon, boys, you go with the yellow balloons. You get one balloon at a time. Everybody say, one at a time. You go get the balloon, you bring it back, you put it on the chair, and you sit on it until it pops. Everybody say, pop.
Pop.
Okay? The first person to pop all three balloons will win this game. Who's going to win this game, Jack? Is it going to be a boys or a girls? Okay. Give him some candy. Give him five candy from this bucket.
The guarding of your heart. And it's so important that you put good things in there and keep it from the bad things like stealing and lying, right? So we want to put good things like we got kindness, which makes you think about others and do good things for other people. And we got love. And we got patience. And patience makes you caring for others. And these are all the things that Jesus can give you if you just ask him. So just like you think your soul is very important, you want to make sure that your heart is more important than you see. And so that's what we want to learn today, is that we value our heart and we put good things like patience and kindness and love within our hearts.
Help me to put good into my heart. Dear God, thank you for loving me. Today I decide that my heart is yours and that my heart is important. Amen.
Amen.
Also, now, boys and girls, today everyone's going to get two packs of Cheez-Its. So I need you all to stay on the tarp till everyone has. And then if you have not filled in a flyer yet, please come and do it so that you can be entered in to win $100.
Hey, y'all, do not mind my hair, okay? It is September 29th, 2:41 p.m. and I haven't been able to vlog because my phone literally was having issues. I had 10,000 items. Huh? Oh, okay. I had 10,000 items in my camera roll, and I deleted 7,000. Why did my gigs of space go up on my phone? And my phone's constantly telling me I have no storage, not even to check my email, not even to take a picture or anything. So I now have a little gig of space, so I don't know how much footage I'll be able to record. This stuff I wanted to record and then I just couldn't, but I'm gonna show you guys what I'm doing right now. So I am making a quick lunch for me and Faith, just some burgers, and yeah, that's what's going on right now. I'm gonna try my best to see if I can fix what's going on with my phone so that I can film for you guys, because this is horrible what's going on. I don't have enough footage for a full vlog with, at the rate that this is going, and I really do need to invest in a camera, and I will. I will. It's just when the time is right. Right now, expenses have been coming up left and right, you know? So when the time is right. Hi, doctor. Insurance. See how it goes. It's not nice to record people without consent, but I don't know what's going on. But this is kids on. Go down the bridge, babe. Alright.
Happy birthday to you. Happy birthday to you. Happy birthday, dear Dorian. Happy birthday to you.
How old are you now?
Four.
Are you four?
Yes, I am.
Yay!
Good job,
Dorian. Okay, I think this noise is too loud. Yay! Good job, Dorian. I'm four. Four. One, two, three, four. Four, okay? Blow it out. Blow it, Dorian. Blow it.
Come on.
Blow your candle out. Yay! Yay! Good job! Good job, Dorian! Yes! Happy birthday, Dorian!
Yeah.
You're just like, yeah, yeah, yeah. Hey, guys. So, it's October 5th. 11:42 a.m. And I know you're like, October 5th? I couldn't record because my phone is really up and up as far as space. Like, I'll explain the problem when I have more space. But yeah, right now I'm with Dorian, and truthfully we're going out Sunday to celebrate his birthday, because his birthday was yesterday, and he might wear the same outfit. But yeah, we're on our way to a school tour right now. I'm not going to be able to record in there because those are other people's children. I don't want to put other people's children on the internet, even though I've done it prior. I'm trying to learn from my mistakes here, so yeah. Adults, with children, no. So yeah, he's with me. Faith is in school and Trent is home with Benny. So this is a school that I've been eyeing for a while. So far, this is a beautiful pathway in here. This is beautiful, and it's such a beautiful day. It's only 75.
And the school is supposed to be right here. If I choose this school, Dorian will have bus service, so we won't have to travel. We did take public transportation. It's a 15-minute walk to the train. We're taking the train 2 stops, and then it's another 15-minute walk. So that's what we had to do today. But if he starts school, it'll be by bus. And here's the building for the school. Let's see what it's like. Probably not even a real exercise, but y'all, it feels good. My ribs have been slipping, so I've been scared to stretch, but oh, I'm getting a cramp in my thigh. Oh my god. Right, y'all, my living room is a mess, and open up the blinds and ready to get it clean, ready to mop. And I don't know, y'all, but I'm exhausted, so I don't even know if I'm gonna get through it. But and then Dorian spilled cereal in the couch earlier this week, and I can't find the other piece. Let me focus it. I can't find the other piece to my vacuum cleaner to get in between the couch, but I'll let you guys know if I find it. Hey y'all, so I'm about to start cleaning and shading up my room, and this is straightening up my room, and this is where the baby's crib was. That's my room. I have some cleaning items there, and I'm about to put the AC on because I'm about to clean mold. So I have, these are my curtains. So far, they are mold-free. I'm hoping and praying. I don't know, because I'm not going to the laundry until Monday. Yeah, I'm gonna... They look like they have some on it. I don't think you guys can see it, but I should have had my mask down before I started filming. But I'm gonna... The baby's in the living room. All three children are in the living room with Dad and... I'm gonna show you guys real quick what's going on in the windows as far as mold goes, and also this window is having a problem too. Just, I had to take that down. I don't really see much. Oh yeah, I do see it. I don't know if you guys can see those black spots in the corner. You probably can't. I'm gonna get a different
angle once I can get my curtains down. And y'all, this new phone has 128 gigs of space, so I can record enough until I get a camera. Let's get into that mode.
None of you can see these black dots here and all of that going on in my window, and it's open right here and I can't close that. I don't know what that white stuff is. And yeah, sometimes the AC gets it too, but Benny cleaned the AC last week and it just looks like it's a little bit going on. And I don't know if this is dust or what, but that definitely looks like mold, right? And so, but this window is where it's really clear, because look at my game cartridge. So I'm gonna throw all that out. I don't know if my candle is molded, but look at the window. It's horrible. It's really bad in this window. So I'm just gonna throw everything here out. You can tell all that. And the problem I had with my bed was this. I'm thinking this is white mold, and it definitely looks like it, and even growing right here. And I also have it right here growing all around here. So yeah, I'm about to clean that with some vinegar and dishwashing liquid for the white mold. And then for the black mold, I have this mold armor. So that's why I have on the gloves and the mask, because this stuff is so strong. It smells like bleach. And it's definitely causes moderate eye irritation. And you're not supposed to get it on your skin or clothing. So I'm just going to be very careful. And you can spray this stuff and wipe it immediately. But I'm going to spray it and let it sit while I do the on the black mold, while I take care of the white mold with the vinegar and whatnot, and then come back and wipe down the black mold.
Now you storming at my house in the middle of the night. I'm trying to sleep. I'm not in love, it's just a game with you. I tell myself I'm not that into you, but I don't wanna sleep.
This stuff is so strong that mold stuff, but this is the hot water, vinegar, and dishwashing liquid. And I just sprayed it where I showed you. And I sprayed it right here, and I could already see it working. I'm gonna take my cleaning toothbrush and go here. And I sprayed it down here. So it's just a mess. This is what I use on the kids' hair. So I couldn't find the other applicator bottle. Then I'm gonna use my cleaning brush. Along with the microwave getting switched out, because that microwave is giving us problems. So yeah, I have my oven preheated on like 200, and I'm gonna slow cook these. I'm starting early so that they can slow cook all day, and by dinner time they'll be ready to eat fresh out the oven. So yes, I'm gonna leave them in about 6 to 8 hours
and I don't know what I'm gonna make them with yet, but yeah, that's what it is right now. So I squeezed sauce on them, and basically I'm just gonna spread that sauce on them, and I'm going to be doing this maybe 3 or 4 times during the 6 to 8 hour process. So this is not the only time I'm going to be adding the sauce, because I like my ribs saucy. I don't know about you guys, but I like mine saucy. So yeah, I need a slow cooker, and I'm going to invest in one when the time is right, but not just yet. So yeah, let me know down below, like, how you guys make your ribs, if you eat ribs. So excuse my hair once again. I'm going to work on washing it next weekend, but I'm sorry for this vlog being all over the place and choppy once again. Like I said, I finally have a phone with space, so I'm going to be able to be more consistent with recording without getting cut off, and able to provide more content that just makes sense, and it's not, you know, everywhere and, oh hey guys, it's a new day, sorry my phone ran out of space. You know, check the description box of my last vlog to see exactly what was going on. But right now I'm about to tackle these dishes. I don't think I'm gonna vlog that, but hopefully I can have some more content to add soon. And I don't know guys, I just appreciate you for rocking with me, because I know it's bumpy here. So round of applause for you guys, for real.
Here they are at the 2 hours, and gonna go ahead and add more sauce on them. I did spill some of the juices, but yeah, this is how they look so far.
Trent is starting to get cranky, so yeah, just gonna, not too much, because this is not the last barbecue sauce application. At least 2 more times I'm gonna be putting this sauce on. Now my ribs come out so saucy. I usually don't like my food messy, but I don't know, for some reason, like, because I do my rib cooking process for so long, I just don't want it to get dried out. So yeah, and I'm far from a novice in the kitchen, but for making ribs for the past couple years, the way I make them, this is just what I learned. I'm just repeating that process that you saw me do before, 2 hours ago, and spreading the sauce all over. Just dabbing it everywhere, not really spreading too much. Now they look saucy again. That's how they look. And I'm going to cover them and back in the oven they go. I'll check on them in another 2 hours, which will be 3 p.m. and I'll show you guys how they are looking then.
Hey y'all, it's been 2 more hours. It's 3 o'clock. You can see all the charmness happening, and they're looking good. Probably leave them in there for 2 more hours and they should be done. And I'm about to repeat the process and sauce some. Put the sweet baby rays all over again and put them back.
So now I'm just gonna go ahead and flip them for the last 2 hours, and I'm gonna have them in the oven. They're already very tender. Like, I'm just trying to pick up some of them with the tongs, and they, ooh, that one got charred pretty badly.
I don't know. Hopefully it don't give a burnt taste. I don't know if you can see that. You can't really see. The lighting sucks. But yeah. That one got charred badly too. So yeah, I'm just gonna flip them. They're already pretty tender, but I want them more tender. Some of them, the meat was falling off the bone, but not all of them, so I know they need more time. So yeah, Dorian recently woke up, so I know he's hungry. He had an emotional breakdown last night. He was up from like 1 a.m. to 6 a.m, so he is just not waking up. So I'm gonna repeat the process that you guys saw. Salsa needs ribs a little bit. Be careful, baby, be careful. I don't want you to get burned. Because I have the oven open, which is not smart. Because Faith and, Dorian and Trent are actively, you know, on the ground. So I gotta get a gate for the kitchen. But yeah, I'm sorry you guys can't really see that well what I'm doing. But yeah, I'm just gonna sauce these, put them back in for another 2 hours. And then I'll show you guys what they look like after that 2 hours. I might put them in the broiler too, just to caramelize the sauce after the 2 hours and to give it a little try too. Yeah. Covering these ribs again. From 11 o'clock this morning, girls, now 3. Next time I'll be checking in will be 5 p.m. Alright, y'all, so it's even more charred. It's not even 5, it's 4:30, but something in my spirit kept telling me to take these things out. And I tried to pick up this one and it just fell apart, y'all. So that's how tender it is. So this is gonna be the one that I look. I can't even pick it up, and that's how I like it. So yeah, I'm about to take these out and show you guys me eating that little piece and put the rest of them away. And they'll probably be for dinner tomorrow. The rest of them did get a little charred, but yeah, I just hope it doesn't have that super charred taste. Like you see this one, I don't know. I just hope it doesn't have that super burnt taste, actually. So maybe 5 hours was enough. So let's see. Here with my fork. It's so tender. Even blowing the piece that I have right here is making it move. That's how I know it's tender and up to my liking. Oh yeah, y'all. It's hot, but and it got that little charred taste. It's so soft, y'all. Oh, I don't like super hot food. This is good. I just need a little more sauce. I'm thinking about, because the oven was drying it out, I'm thinking about putting it in a container, putting some sauce in it, and just shaking that around to make it extra saucy. But yeah, it's good. That's good, y'all. It doesn't taste burnt. It's as if you grilled it. That's why I rarely make ribs, because I like to put them in there all day. And I hope all the pieces taste like this, because I do taste a little bit of charring too. I don't want too much though. But yeah, I hope all the pieces taste like this, because last time I took it out and only one piece, like the piece that I tested was tender, was nice, it was good. And then the rest of them weren't like that, so. I don't know. Yeah, see, that piece I just ate wasn't tender. That makes me feel like the rest of it is not tender. Like, they're falling apart if they are, though. But that's what fooled me last time. I think I needed to... Every 2 hours was not soon enough to check them. And I charred them. So, I don't know if the family is gonna like this, but I don't know. I feel horrible because I did all this work and it's like, still not that good. Ooh, I just burnt my finger getting some, accidentally touching one of the other ribs. That little piece I just ate was tender, but the piece before that wasn't. I don't know what to do. I'll figure it out. All right, y'all, so the charredness was a little bit too much for me. And I don't know if all of the pieces are tender. So I didn't leave the ribs in as long as I would have liked. Don't ask me why I'm taking them out now. There's no reason. It's just, it was charring so much that I was worried. Like, I didn't want it to have this charred taste. And now that I look at them, this lighting sucks. They don't look that charred. Here's Dorian here with me. See them? And so, it's not saucy enough for me, and I want the sauciness to kind of combat some of that charredness. So I'm taking some honey and that same sauce that I was using, and just adding honey to it, more honey to it, because I know it. Let me take the cap off this, because I need a good amount, y'all. And literally just taking a fork and mixing those two together. Taste it. Y'all, the ratio has to be right. I ain't gonna eat it. And I'm just gonna pour it all over them. I should have used more because that doesn't seem like enough. But hey, they can add more on their own meal. I didn't caramelize it in the broiler or anything. Like, excuse me, baby. I'm gonna close it. Make sure it's tight. You know, this can only get so tight. It's not staying closed. These are these little IHOP to-go trays, so they're not real Tupperware, and it just keeps opening. Let's give it a quick toss. There's one of the ribs that actually fell off the bone. That's how I wanted all of them to be, but okay, now they're a little more saucy to my liking. Now they look saucier. I just hope they taste a little sweeter too. Yes, I'm gonna pick off a piece. See how tender it is, y'all? It's crazy. I wish all the pieces were like this. So good, it's good, y'all. That's good. Okay, I'm gonna leave them alone now. But there you have it. So I just took all of our things off the microwave, and this is Dorian's little pancakes, so I'm about to just break these up for him. And I took everything off. I meant to record that part, but I forgot. So yeah, you're about to see me
move it, and this thing has been here for almost 3 years. It's been sitting in this exact same spot. I have not moved it, I have not cleaned under it or anything. So yeah, that's just what it is. Okay, we can go to the table and eat, baby. Come on. Careful, don't drop it. Alright, so, yeah, I don't know. I'm seeing everything for the first time, just like you guys are, and I don't know what to expect. I expect it to be completely disgusting under this microwave. So, we got some plastic straws here. I guess I'll save those because Faith loves to drink out of straws. I did buy some reusable plastic ones though. So that's good. And I'm still seeing on the lot. There's a fruit snack packet. This is a little tape gun. I didn't really like the way this worked. I haven't seen this in a very long time. So it's interesting. Dorian can have that fruit snack pack. Y'all, the big reveal. I'm so freaking nervous. Cause I just know it's disgusting. Oh my god, this sugar. Oh my gosh. Oh my goodness, y'all. This is so freaking gross. I'm gonna have to put gloves on. Oh my goodness, this is horrible. Okay, I was just trying to make sure there was like no pests or anything. I'm gonna give y'all a closer look. Ooh, it's a little heavier than I thought. Do you guys see that? My microwave. Like, that is gross. That is so freaking disgusting. This is like french fries and everything, so I'm gonna speed up the clip, but you guys are gonna see me cleaning it. I'm gonna grab a pair of gloves because some of this stuff has had to have been here for a very long time. So yeah, you're gonna see me throw every single thing here in the trash and literally get it clean and prepared for the new microwave. And what I'm gonna be using, I love these. These are good for grease splashes on your back wall. I did mention these in my house cleaning vlog a couple videos back. But this is the lemon fresh scent. I never tried this one. But yeah, they have soap in them, y'all. So it's real good for those grease stains and, you know, cleaning your stove and stuff. So I'm going to be using that to clean the area and hoping for the best. Nice. Yeah, so these little settings. Pretty cool. I'm gonna have to do a separate time on it. But yeah. We're all set, guys. So y'all, this is the groceries. They just came. So right now I'm about to get them set up on the table so I can put them away. It's eating. And Trent and Dorian are watching Gracie's Corner as usual. Hey, go play. Go play. So here's everything, y'all. It doesn't look like as much stuff now, does it? So yeah, that's everything we got. Minus like some chips, bread, and I got these seasoning. Some stuff. Some apple juice for Chad. Taco sauce. Oh, excuse me. But thank you, sweetheart. And then I got some Cheetos and Lay's for the kids. So yeah, not to put all the stuff away. I'm not gonna film that, but because yeah, I really need to take my time, see where everything goes. My fridge is not cleaned yet. I have to like take everything out, clean it, organize it, and stuff like that. So yeah. All this baby food for Trent. He's still on the purees. So, yeah, let's get it put away. Hey, y'all. So, it's the next day. It's October 16th at 11:30 a.m. Faith has a bowling trip with her school today. So, I hope she's having fun. But I'm ending this vlog here. I really hope you guys enjoyed it, even though it was kind of all over the place. This is one of my longest vlogs yet. But let me know what you guys would like to see. Any suggestions. And I will see you guys in the next one. Have a blessed week.